So hello everyone, this is River, and today we are going to do the solids lab. Before the experiments, you guys have already read the protocols. And here is a summary of the protocols. And so basically, we have 5 experiments. Although we have 5 separate experiments, but because we will spend some time for the baking, so during the baking, we can prepare for the next one. So finally, we can finish it within 3 hours. So this is a sample, and this sample is the wastewater, and it is taken from the wastewater treatment plant. For this experiment, we need the glass pipette to grab the wastewater sample, like this one. And we also need the evaporation dish in here, and we need the filter. We also have the aluminum plate that's shown here. And this is a filtration system. We can separate it as this. And when we do the vacuum, we can just open the water. So it can create the vacuum. Okay, so let's get started.
So we have all of the stuff in this detector because we want to avoid water gets into our equipment. And so the first one is the total solid. We just grab the evaporation dish. And then we can measure the weight of this one. And in the data sheet, so this is the initial mass of the dish. We can write down this. So this is the initial mass of the dish. And then we are going to take 15 milliliter of the samples. So we need to take 15 mils of the wastewater samples into the dish. Before, when we take the samples, we need to ensure the sample is suspended, it is mixed. And then put it here. And then we transfer it to 180 degree oven. So this is 180 oven. We use the freezer to put it into the oven. And then we make it for 45 minutes. Mm-hmm. And then we can go to the next one. And so for the next one, we are going to use the filtration. So still, we need to raise the mass of this one. And then this is the mass of another evaporation dish. And then we can write down the mass because this one is a dissolved solid. So this should be 3 times in here. And then we are going to use the filtration system. So basically, we lay the filter here. And then we still have this system. And you still have the cooling system. And after that, they just remove the to make sure that it's clean. And then we can take 15 mils of sample. So it is. And then put this into the filter and then use the vacuum to filter it for 3 minutes. And during this, we can jump the water to make sure there is no residues on the pipe. And after 3 minutes, we can just throw this. It's very dirty. And then we put this to here. And then we put this to 103 degree oven. So still we need to do this very carefully. And bake this for 45 minutes. And then the next step is to measure the dissolved solid. So still we need to measure the initial mass. And by this time, we need to measure the initial mass of the plate with the filter. And then we put this. And take down the mass. So this is the first one, the second one. And then the second one.
How do you know what is the first one and what is the second one? Do you have to mark them?
Yeah, I can make a scratch on the second one. And then, yeah, so we can write down the mass of this two. And then we are going to lay the filter into. And then we put 15 milliliters of the waste water sample. And then from there, we have to rinse. And after 3 minutes, we take the filter and put the filter into. And then they take it.
I need to buy all three.
Then we are going to do the fifth one. The first one we are going to do it at last because we don't have 1 liter wastewater. So for demonstration, I will do this first. Do the turbidity. So basically, we have this turbidity vial right here. So we need to make sure it is clean. We take about 20 mils. Or 22 or 25 because we use this to grab, so we can make it sure it is 22 or something along this volume. And then. So this is a bit of a meter, we don't need to calibrate it first. So we can just put this inside, it can get the reading. But we know that the solids they are trying to settle down. So the turbidity will change. So we just shake it before we put it in, and then we get the first reading that we have. So the volume is 22, and the reading is 1, 4, 3, 9. Mm-hmm. This will keep changing, but it doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. And then we do it for the second time. And finally, we are going to do the this one, the sixth one of the solids. To do this experiment. We need this cone, and you can write your book down. And then we can see here is the scale of 1 liter, or of 1 liter. And then here are the scales for measuring the solids. Because I don't have the 1 liter wastewater sample today, so I just use all of this. Now we have 1 liter of the wastewater sample. So we can just wait when it's settling down. And now it is after 54 minutes. So I'm going to take the sample out. And we need to make sure it is completely dry. And now it seems to be dry. And then we send it into the designator. We also take our samples. And it seems to be completely dry. So we should have 2 sets of this, but here I only have 1 for demonstration. So, okay, so now after 10 minutes, we can measure the weight of this. And this is a total solid. We can see there are many solids on it. And then we measure the weight of this one. And then this mass is the mass after 103. So basically, the mass is this one. And then we can calculate the residues by making the difference of these two. And also, we can take this out. Measure the weight of the dissolved solids. Measure the weight. And then, take out the mass. It's something like this. And then, measure the weight of this still. And then get the weight of this. And then we can calculate the residues. After making the mass, we are going to put them into the 500 oven. So this is 500 and 50 degrees oven, and it is very hot inside. We can see the inside. But when we are reading this, we need to wear this glove. So we can see it's very hot inside. Okay. So then we are going to put all of these samples into the oven. Into the oven. And then we should wait this for about 50 minutes. So now it is after 50 minutes, we are going to take them out. And then it is air dry for several minutes. After that, we can transfer them into the designator to make them cold down to the room temperature. So we just wait for about 10 minutes. And during the waiting, we can check this. So we can see the color. Oops. Here, and this is the storage that we are going to have. And then after 50 minutes, we just cool down for the room temperature. We can raise the mask. So now we have another mask, and this mask is the mask after 550. So it is something like this. And then. And then we are going to measure the dissolved solids. And then take down the mask here. After that, we are going to measure the mass of this. So for this one, we can take down the mass after 550. So we have almost done everything, and then we are going to write down this. How much of this?
It's four.
Four? So it is 4 mL. And that's it.